Hey guys, Saminator here, doing a platinum solo guide using the Juggernaut. Right, my specs. Hex shield, I've got damage, shock, pulse. Well, actually, let's read it the other way. Pulse, shock, damage synergy. Yeah, that's better. Siege pulse, I've got damage, damage protection, number of shots. I'm gonna be mostly just keeping it on my shoulder. The only times I'll be using it is to cause fire explosions using my incendiary rounds. Geth Juggernaut, weapon damage, stability and ammo, and weapon damage. Nearly said headshot damage, but I forgot he has no headshot damage. Oops. Hardened platform, I have durability, shield recharge, power transfer. Even though it does weaken my damage by 15%, I have to deal with it. I am a Juggernaut. I am there to tank, not to kill. Well, apart from a solo, I'm planning a kill. I've got Riga Carbine with incendiary rounds, so that's going to be quite powerful because Juggernaut's not really good with that many weapons. He's also good with a particle rifle, but in a solo I thought, since everything's going to be coming up close to me and stuff, I think the Riga will be a lot better than the particle rifle. And I also have Cyclonic 4. I'm not going to do Adrenaline Module 3 because it's not really much of a bump at all, because it's like base speed is really low. Armored compartments, just to make sure I have over 8 missiles in case I have 2 objectives that are both targets, because it might be a bit tricky trying to chase down a target running away from me with just a Riga. So, same stuff, unknown, unknown, platinum, let's do this. Oh yes. Okay, that's not too bad. This zone needs to be locked down. Incoming hostile forces. If anything, Giants, well, a good map. Just gonna keep high-fiving the air. Anyway, yeah, same as the ghost thing, I'll be throwing in tips and stuff, so priorities are a little bit different now that I'm the Juggernaut. I can actually safely say that I can go for Phantoms because I can just ragdoll them like this and just shoot them down like that. Really easy to deal with. You stop going around the block, please. There we go. Oh god, there's something hitting me in the back. Combat Engineer. There we go. The damage over time of my incendiary rounds and fire explosion is going to be quite painful for the Atlases and armored bosses, as you can see, so yeah, it's going to be pretty fun. Oh yeah, if you ever have 2 or less siege pulses on your shoulder, just shoot it out and regenerate it back, because you need that damage taken bonus. It's what keeps you alive, really. What the hell, Phantom? Where are you going? There we go. Yeah, I was actually planning to move around in this video, but everything seems to be coming for me, so I might actually stay here more often, I guess. Seems to be working. Boom. Hey, Trooper. No, Atlas, give me time to get ammo at least, please. I don't want a thermal clip on the first wave. Oh, hey. Yeah, combat engineers are worth a lot of points, and I think I killed quite a few, so I wouldn't be surprised if the wave budget is, like, nearly done. If so, that's like, yeah, wow, that's a very fast wave 1 for being a Juggernaut. Oh my god, that was faster than an actual, a solo game using a really, powerful character, like a ghost or even a GI. I actually forgot I had no siege pulse on my shoulder. I was, like, thinking I was gonna shoot it out. Oops. Let's just sit here for a second, regenerate my ammo. That should do. Don't forget to walk backwards, you walk a little bit faster. Make sure these engineers don't plant any turrets here too, otherwise that's going to be annoying, like that. Sorry, like all of my shots were missing there, that was a bit silly. Dragoons are going to be more tough because they rush really hard and can keep staggering you constantly, so I got to keep an eye on them. Like that. Luckily I can stagger them back. Oops, again, I forgot that I didn't have Siege Pulse one at a time. Okay, now's a good time to start moving. Yes, I know, I'm a Juggernaut and I can still climb a ladder, that's amazing. I was surprised that even hit him, I thought that was gonna hit the wall. Again, the wave budget is nearly over, guys, so first two waves pretty much finished in like, what, really short amount of time? What the? What are you both doing? Yeah, that can't even reach that Atlas, let's try and... I'd rather go for one at a time, but they're being really douchey at the moment. Oh, give me ammo, you silly box. There we go. He's headshotting me. I was, like, behind that wall and he could still hit me. Look at that Atlas just die, pretty much. How easy it is. Oh, Hex Shield killed it, that's even better. Look at that damage over time, look at that go. Oh yes. Okay, this may be a little bit annoying. No. There we go. Your top priority is locating that object. Sucks that this object is in the complete opposite corner of the map. Luckily, Juggernaut surprisingly walk faster with the object, as you can see, going a little bit faster. It's amazing, isn't it? It's pretty much just space logic, so... I'm not going to question it though, it's making me go faster. If anything, the object is an enhancement to my survival, just to go a little bit faster. Get the object back to the extraction zone. Let's go this way actually, just to be safe. I mean, I can pass the Atlas, but I don't want the missile staggering me. I'm hoping the next object is somewhere closer. Experimental power source lost. Not really that close, but... Yeah, same as every solo I've done, I'm gonna take my time, I'm not gonna rush and take risks and anything like that, it's not worth it. Your top priority is locating that object. I'm gonna rotate this way, so go all the way up to the building, then round, you know, like up there and to the extraction. Because now that I'm down here, everything is gonna slowly work its way down here, apart from the Atlas, not sure what the Atlas is doing. Again, walking backwards just to give me that little speed bump.
Good. Get back to the extraction zone.
See, nothing here, apart from the two axes that seem to be stuck again. Okay. Oh, that hurts. Wow, they're not, like, they actually gave me time to regenerate my shield. Thank you, Atlases. Seriously though, what are they doing? Oh yeah, I think they fixed Hex Shield so the like Ravager shots don't go through it anymore. So that's really good. Wondering where the Phantoms were that whole time. Again, resisting the temptation to missile that entire group because you want to save your missiles. Oh, come on. Yeah, I'll pack it. Just I'll pack it. It's not worth the beating. Because I had only one Siege Pulse left, so they got a good time on me. No, heavy melee, you silly. Oh, never mind. I'll off-pack it again. Sorry, that was really bad. My Juggernaut decided to just be stupid and not heavy melee. I was planning not to use any equipment these first three waves, but the game decided to troll me, I believe. Only one Siege Pulse or two Siege Pulses. Yeah, let's regenerate it. Give me the ammo, come on! Oh my god. Ah. I forgot Atlas missiles can somehow go through that. Either that or it's because they were on high ground. Not too sure. I want my right hand advantage, but I can't get it from here. Unless... let's do that way. Come on. There we go. Wave sweep, well done. Enemy is regrouping. Enemy force approaching. So now I just need to go all the way back round. Nemesis. Ow. Okay, there's a lot of enemies there. That might be a bit tricky. Okay, plan B, let's go around this way. Same as the Touring Ghost video, not going to go for the Banshees at all. Oh, sorry, badly timed Siege Pulse. You want to remember to shoot it as they're about to do their little barrier explosion thing, or when they're regenerating their aura, or anything like that. Not whilst they're standing still warping, like now, like that. Looks like I will be going this way then, since the Banshee's there. I forgot there's a Marauder in this wave. Oh, that's a Nemesis, what am I saying? Yeah, since all the targets are mostly going to be camping around, it's actually okay to go for Banshees when you have a Juggernaut. Because everything's just going to casually take its time getting to you anyway. Double Banshee wave though for wave 5, out of the question, don't go for the Banshees, because the other one will keep, like, trolling you by punching you in the face, forcing you to just take all the hits, get staggered and not be able to heavy melee, etc. Oh, yeah, sorry, that was my bad. I wasn't really paying attention there. I was actually just about to get my coffee, so I just hit left bumper and wasn't really paying attention to her stance. So ignore that. There we go, now I can do it. Can't even reach that Ravager, apparently. Committed suicide, okay. It's like, I don't want to live anymore. Oh, I didn't realize there's still spawning more enemies. And I forgot I can't jump over cover either. Let's go this way. In fact, I was doing good in this building here, so let's just go back in here and see how it goes. Go with the flow. Okay, I'm not even sure how that hit me, but oh well. Yeah, fire explosion does actually do quite a decent amount of damage, doesn't it? Oh wow, he didn't die from damage over time, I'm really surprised. Oh hey, combat engineer. Oh no, ammo, shit, I forgot. Your guns tickle me, you're no match for me. Oh, you came down for me, how sweet. Boom.
Well done, team. Stay alert, enemy is regrouping. Bogey's incoming.
Acknowledged. This wave has phantoms in it too, so like, again, they're really easy to kill. Just ragdoll them and do what you like with them, whatever. Just torture them, basically. Get lots of points, finish the wave budget early. Ravager's also easy to kill. Centurion's easy to kill. Double Banshee, you want to avoid this wave, pretty much. If you know it's just one Banshee chasing you and the other one's just doing its own thing, then fine, go for it. But don't take too many risks. There we go. Heh, 5 headshots, like a boss. Of course, Banshee melee stagger. I think I'm making a mistake here because yeah, I don't have enough siege pulses left, I just realized, so now I am in the death trap, unfortunately. Might be able to recover though, if I'm lucky. No. No way, apparently the Ravager just bypassed my hex shield from wherever it was standing. Yeah, just gotta up-pack, unfortunately, get my siege pulse back. And that is how easy it is to be overrun by enemies. Like, as soon as that Banshee staggers you and you're punched, yeah, that's pretty much when the enemies begin to rush you. Because you're forced to heavy melee and then you die like that. It's fine, I've only used one gel. Nope. So let's just stay back here and just relax for now. Again, it's only one Banshee I can see, not sure what the other one is, so I'm gonna try and go for it. And it worked! Wrong button. I accidentally done light melee when I didn't want to. And again, I only have 2 siege pulses left, so see if I can quickly shoot it out as soon as I get here. And recover. There we go. Okay, I think I have time to get this one actually. There we go. I was being a bit risky there, I noticed my shield kept going down from those ravagers. Yeah, wave budget's still not nearly done at all, so I need to get back round. Not gonna go for that Banshee, because I know the other Banshee's really close to it now. So you're just keeping my cool, relaxing. Yeah, I prefer the ravagers to be up here so I can kill them, but yeah, that other Banshee's gonna be gone for a while, so I can actually go for this one. Okay, the other Banshee's gonna start moving in a sec, so I need to quickly get this, where did you come from? I don't think I killed the Banshee, no I didn't. Yeah, I'm gonna thermal clip that. There we go. Really not letting me regenerate my shields. There we go. Oh, sticking to walls. Yeah, far too enemies hit. Here I need to like kind of get out, but I think the wave budget is also nearly done, so I guess after all that I might as well stay. Just use my leaf blow on it. Didn't even know that Centurion was still alive. Give me shield swarmer, thank you. You too. Like, double Banshee waves are always going to be the longest when using a Juggernaut, for obvious reasons. There we go. Piece of cake. Down to Hack, okay. Hacks tend to be, like, pretty nice for the Juggernaut. Okay, that's definitely not good. I think the enemies are spawned here. Oh, if it's just the Atlases, maybe I can deal with it now. Thermal clip. Fire explosion, and shoot. Again, not taking any risks. I'm not planning to stay in the ring the entire time on my first attempt, because I may need to move. Can you go away, Atlas? Well, actually, I still have 9 missiles, and the hack's actually nearly done. I might as well stay in the ring. Recover siege pulses. Thank you. Yeah, I think it was worth the missile. I've got 8 missiles now for the last few waves, so yeah, this is actually really easy. And there are 5 enemies left. No more hunters, 1 bomber, 2 axes, 2 guardians. Because wave 6 consists of 2 bombers, 2 guardians, 2 atlases, and 2 hunters. And the bombers are pretty much gone now, and so are the hunters. So it's just the atlases and guardians left. And they're all pretty much slow-moving targets too, so... It would help if they'd stop staggering me though, so I can get out of here. There we go. Are you kidding me? Just want to regenerate my shield. Oh, there we go. Anyway, where are the guardians? Or did I already kill them? I don't think I killed them. No? Alright, and I might as well go for the Atlas if I can't find the guardians. Oh, they are there. I was like, what the hell were they? They must have been stuck behind the Atlas. Enemy is regrouping. Bogies incoming. Message received. Enemy. There we go. The Dragoon and Phantom rushing wave. Pretty much like wave 2, and you saw how fast wave 2 finished, so it's basically a repeat. Everything on this wave is worth quite a lot of points. So as long as you keep your cool, then you can finish this wave really fast too. Just don't get rushed too much, and like, end up using medigel, because wave 7 you can do fairly well. So you don't want to end up using anything on a wave that you didn't really need to, you know? I forgot I didn't have Siege Pulse on, that was quite bad, but I recovered quick. So, it's getting over on, I'm gonna start moving now. I mean, look how over on it is up there straight away. Even the Pyro's got it really quick. Did all the Phantoms miss? I'm really surprised. Even the Dragoon's whips missed. Wow. I think they're all drunk. Silly Cerberus. Oh, there's a phantom. I wasn't sure if I killed it or not, because it just like disappeared. I missed a Dragoon, oh my god. And you missed me! Aha! The Siege Pulse is also really good just for that stagger, especially with the fire explosion. But as you can see, yeah, the fire explosions and siege pulse combo is really powerful. Ah, I'm not gonna make it. I'm not gonna make it back. Bronze waves and silver waves, like a boss. I'm hoping they didn't spawn in the building, because that's where I want to go right now. Oh no, that's good, they spawned here. I mean, over there. So, three pyros, really easy to kill. Got Atlas's phantoms, and of course, a prime. Luckily, the Juggernaut with Riga Carbine does fairly well against Geth Primes anyway, so they're actually not a threat. Combat drone is a little bit because of the stagger, but that's really it. Oh, come on! These guys are taking forever to get here. It looks like the Prime and Atlas is going to get here first. Yeah, look, what the hell? Silly Phantom. It was probably a plan to hold me off. I mean, like, to hold me here. Cheeky. That's a prime. For a second there, I thought that was a pyro coming around the corner, but no, I was completely wrong. Ah, getting stuck to a wall as usual. Ow. There we go. Just used it just to get a little bit of shield back, just to be safe. Oh, I'm surprised that range actually got all the way from here. No, Phantom blocking the ladder. Oh, I just made it out of that. I thought I would have had to like use an op pack there, but I survived. Goddamn host damage. Taking a beating here, yeah, I got an op pack it. Told you, heavy melee, death trap, I've only got one op pack now. So I'm not going to use it. If I start losing my shields again, I'll just use a medi gel rather than op pack, because that might come in handy. So watch how much damage I do to the Geth Prime. Well, after I deal with the Phantom first, but as you can see, like, pretty much lost all its shield. Ah! Geth Turret. Can't even hit it from here, goddammit. 10 headshots. I don't even want to question that. May go down, not sure yet. Yeah, there we go. That's fine, I needed to get all my health sequence back anyway. Oh, come on, Phantom, how did you hit me from there? I was being cocky, oh man. Still, as you can see, though, the Juggernaut Platinum solo is really easy to do as long as you keep your cool and just relax. Obviously, try not to take as many risks as I did, otherwise that would get you killed, maybe. Really, combat drone? Really? Yeah, climbs are really easy, as you can see. So if it was a Geth game, this still would have been really easy. Can you stop hitting me, please? Let me just, like, get some ammo. There we go. I'm not sure like how long this game's been, but it doesn't feel like it's really been that long. It feels like a Platinum Pug game, the time at the moment. Probably balanced out due to Wave 1 and 2 going really fast. Did you just cancel roll there? I'm hoping you guys saw that, because wow. There's a Banshee going, oh. Oh god, I've got no siege pulse, whoops. There we go. Yeah, I was taking a bit of damage there, I only had one siege pulse on my shoulder. Goon coming, I'm hoping the shield will stun him. Yep, there we go. See, now the Atlas is all the way over there, so it's going to take a while to get here, which is really good. As for the Banshee, she's keeping up so well that I might actually, yeah, I'm going to have to kill her, because she's keeping up too well. Stop interfering, Dragoons. Kind of having 1v1 here, obviously. The battle between the Banshee and the Prime, yeah. Did you really not die from that? I was hoping it would also get stunned, but it chose not to get stunned, which is annoying. Yeah, I should have used Nullpack there, but I got staggered quite badly. And I'm obviously still getting staggered, but hopefully that shield will stop some of the Dragoons. Nope, apparently not. Can you just go away, Dragoon, for a sec? Let me regenerate. Nope. They're walking right through it at the moment. There we go. Of course, Banshee Warp. Of course. Oh, so close. So close. Just the Dragoons were really persistent there. Thermal clipping it. There we go. How did that hit me? Come on. And that. Oh god, I forgot this is quite a big wave budget. I need to start being more careful. There's always something blocking the ladder at the time. Every single time it'll do that. Okay, there might just only be two enemies left, I'm not sure. Ah! Give me my shield back. Gonna go back up here this time. I don't trust the Atlas missile staggering and the Banshee warp and stuff, it might actually kill me. So I'm not gonna take any risks, I'm gonna let it come back up here. There we go. Oh, I didn't even have to siege pulse it. Just casually having a little stroll. There we go. That was a good lob. Wait, I can't be the last enemy. It's not the last enemy. Where's the other enemy? Or is it two Atlases? I'm not sure. I think it's two. Yeah, two. That was a fail siege pulse there. Sorry about that. And that wasn't even a fire explosion. Not surprised. I messed up. Oh yeah. Canister of experiment. This again? Oh wow, that one's actually right there. Find it and bring it in. Nice work. Get back to the extraction zone. Whoa, 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 whoa. Oh my god, nearly died there. Oh, there's a phantom right there, that could have killed me. I think the hex shield saved me. Oh, can't jump over cover, forgot. Okay, I still have 8 missiles left, so I'm actually going to start using them in order to just make this go nice and fast. Well, I don't really care too much about the Banshee, so... Piece of cake! Awesome! Alright, 6 enemies left. Wanna wait for them to all line up in one missile, maybe? I wanna at least get a few, you know? Oh, that was quite bad. Oops. Oh, no, I don't really need to missile you, actually. You're just one enemy. Game would have been a piece of cake. Collector, questionable, simply because Praetorians may keep slapping you in the face. I'm gonna miss all this simply because there's a lot of stuff here. Yeah, I kind of figured the Atlas explosion would kill the other Atlas, that's why I left it. Okay, missile time, might as well. Killspeak, it's like, how did they even all get there so fast? I'm gonna attempt to circle the map with my two remaining medigels and three thermal clip packs because everything's stuck there, I think. I'm not sure. I still have a good 40 seconds though, so I'm gonna leave my hex shield here to stall the enemies like that. Zap. Oh, this is easy. Oh dear, no. Not sure if I'm gonna make it now, actually, now that I look at the time. I keep forgetting, I can't run, so I wasn't meant to. No! I'm so close! Let me just. Yeah, I've got it, it's fine. I got this! Hex shield completion! Good timing! Oh, 45 minutes 40. That's actually not bad, considering I'm a juggernaut as well. Have another well-deserved sip of my coffee. I got quite a few things coming up on the right side of my screen. Nice. So anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed my little solo platinum with the Juggernaut. If you guys would like me to solo anything else, then feel free to leave a little YouTube comment. I will most likely be posting this on BSN2, so keep an eye if you see a topic. But anyway, I'll see you guys soon!